jabbed, and he got out combination, if that's a word, you know, whatever it is. You know, right there, those are, I mean, clean. I mean, it's not even like you can argue the fact. You know what I'm saying? Like, Deontay is the kind of fighter where, you know, if he's out jabbing you, he's probably going to win the fight. But if he's getting out jabbed, he's probably going to lose the fight. You know what I'm saying? He's got that build. He's got that style. You know, he's like his trainer, Mark Breland. You know, Mark Breland would never really let a guy out jab him. You know, he's got to start from that, and then it builds into everything else. Deontay has the build where if he's going to win a fight, he's got the big right hand, but his jab is the key. His jab is the key. He's got the build and he's got the style for that. You know what I'm saying? And that's kind of his key to victory. He knows it, and I think most people know. But if his jab is good enough, it doesn't matter who knows it. You know what I'm saying? Like, Breland had a great jab. It didn't matter if you knew you had to stop Breland's jab when you were fighting him. If you, most of the time, the guys couldn't stop it. You know? So I think it's the same thing for Deontay. He just has to make sure his jab is unstoppable and not get himself in a situation like he did with the Fury fight the first time around.
Round 6 through 12, how did you have it?
You
gave him one of the first five.
Yeah, and then I gave him eight and 12.
The knockdown. Yeah, the knockdown.
Round,
whatever.
I still give him 10-8. I mean, you he didn't win the rest of the either round. He got, after the knockdowns, Fury actually got up. If it wasn't for those knockdowns, he loses those rounds too. You know what I'm saying? Like Fury got up on the rest of and the remainder of those knockdown rounds.
If I was 6'5", I'll be in the NBA.
Yeah, of course. But what I'm saying is, that's why I gave him 10-8. If you were 6'5", you'd be in the NBA.
No, even if he was 7'5", he wouldn't be in the NBA.
I understand the point you're making. I understand the point you're making, so I'm going to go with it. Instead of saying whatever, right, I'm going to go with it. That's why I gave him the 10-8 round regardless.
Yeah, that's what I did. You know what I'm saying?
So I didn't care if Fury won the rest of the round. I gave Deontay the 10-8 round.
Did Fury's taunting sway you or any other
one? Taunting?
Nah, I don't care. You know, the head taunting, the hand behind the back.
No.
Kind of sway somebody
over there. No, I think the out jabbing and then the combination punch. Really, combination punch is a big key there, bro. I mean, Deontay didn't throw a combination all night, bro.
So you literally think the style in which you
find
throw
me a combination.
Punches.
Find me a combination. Deontay threw that night. The 2-3 and 12 round was the right hand. He's already hurting, and the three comes.
That's still a combination.
Okay,
it's still a combination.
He gets a 10-8 round. Yeah. Throw me another combination. Find me another combination.
That's the most memorable one. Okay, so I would have to.
You're not gonna find one. You're gonna find this. One, two, three, four.
So you
can find those. Those aren't combinations. Those are consecutive punches. A combination is because you're balanced enough to put it together. If you're not balanced enough to put it together, those are consecutive punches. They're not in combination. And regardless, that's why he missed them. Because if he's able to be balanced enough to put them in a combination instead of as consecutive punches, he probably lands some of those in some of those situations where he's missing, four or five at a time in a row. You know what I mean? But because they're one at a time and he's not balanced, he's not able to put it together. Now again, this isn't personal. Like, I feel like Deontay took it personal. Like, this is me feeling like I'm. It's not just boxing. For me, it's like I said. I wish the best on both guys when they get in the ring. Bro, I know how hard this is to make a living. You know what I'm saying? So I wish the best for both guys when they get in the ring. And if somebody gets hard done by, I'll argue for them. You know what I mean? But if they don't, they don't. You know what I mean?
Yo, what's in up, what bro? Country? Italy? Shit.
Not even, bro.
Not right.
I got too many scandals.
So do you think that taunting maybe caused Fear or caused Wilder to start overthrowing and threw him out of his game?
You know what I really think, looking back, I think Fury is underrated in that he's very big. He's a very big guy. You know what I mean? Like, he's tall. And yeah, he's tall. You get in a clinch with him, it's like a tree trunk. Yep, you know what I'm saying? Like he's big. So you got to suddenly find range. And you're looking at him. You know, it's one thing to talk to him. When you find yourself in front of him, and you're like, you know, sometimes you find yourself in front of somebody. And, you know, you've been in front of him at the press conference. One night, you find yourself like, oh shit, you know what I mean? This is
a little bit different.
You know what I mean? Like, I just feel like it was a little different. You know what I mean? It's hard to find a sparring partner to mimic a guy like Fury because he's got weird movement. He's very nimble. I think that's part of why he doesn't punch hard that hard, is because he's not really sitting on a lot of his shots because he's so nimble. But his nimbleness makes him.